seriously for one reason. The reason that we are all living, no matter how long we stay, how long we be on the surface of the earth, we are living. And our life on the surface of earth could be compared to 1 second, to the length of the life in the life to come for all of us. But Allah has provided us with all the means to live in peace during this 1 second on earth, to earn eternity when we be with Him. When people are decaying, or their age is passing very fast, remember, young people, that life, the second to live on earth, could end at any time. Anywhere, anyhow, by any means. We are living, because we are going to live, to live. Our life, when we live again, could be either joy or no joy. Could be either with Allah or with in the depth of hellfire. With the hypocrite and the non-believers. We are living because we have to live. We can't live forever here because this 1 second on earth is what we need to achieve in it what can give us the wealth of the kingdom of heaven. What to do? Make your heart to accommodate 7 or 8 billion people. Make your heart to accommodate the earth, 26,000 kilometers, which is the diameter or the circumference of earth. Make your heart to accommodate the galaxies, the planets that Allah has created for you to discover and to benefit from. Make your heart to be with every and any creation of Allah, because you are the custodian of His message and you are the follower of the teacher of humanity and the teacher of the teachers and the teachers and the leaders of all the prophets. This 200-300 gram piece of flesh will be able to accommodate all this and more. And will tell Allah, I need more, I need more, I need more. Because I need to live to accommodate more creation, more wealth of what you have given us. We are living because we have to live, can't stay forever. We are living to be saved by the people that we claim that we are serving. We are living to be at the cliff of hellfire. When a young, miserably looking child, will pull us from the edge of the hellfire, from the cliff, and telling it Allah and pointing to Allah, no, don't let him or her to fall in hellfire. But we are living because we have to live. We are living because we cannot stay. Because when you see the life to come, you love it. Because it's been prepared to you by the hand of Allah, the garden, the roads, the dust, the smell, the clothes, the food, everything being created by Him, specially made for each and every one of you. And He wants you to live. But when He wants you to live, He wants you to leave a legacy behind you. Legacy in the people that you bow yourself down for. Legacy for the people that you really serve them. Legacy for the people that you really love them and they loved you. That's why you are leaving behind the love. Love is legacy, not a building, not a road. Love is the legacy that you need to leave behind. So we are leaving. Whether we can extend, try to inject some injection in our blood to give us more life. Nobody can live more forever. I was listening to a story, just to conclude with, of some young boy. who was in a very difficult situation in certain countries, torture, and he developed an untreatable leukemia. They tried with him everything. 5 remedies of different medicine. All of them failed. It was too late. And the doctor sat him down. He was mid-20s, at your age. The doctor sat him down and was explaining to him that within a day or a week you are dying. You know what he asked the doctor to do? I want you to measure my eyesight and give me a new glasses. Said, are you serious? I'm telling you that you're dying. And you tell me new glasses. Yes, I want to read the Quran. I want to be with Allah. I want to be surrounded by the words of Allah. I don't want to be dying, not being able to live, to read the word of wisdom of Allah. Because when you live in the shade of the Quran, you'll be shaded by the mercy of Almighty Allah. We are living, we should be shaded as well. We are living, but we should be living behind this legacy of love to each and every one of us. When you made this impact on this society, money is not impact, status is not impact, wealth is not impact, your heart, and the belief in the mission of humanity is what makes the impact. Remember the story of the dying young man at the age of 20s something, and he was not caring. He said, Hazrat Muhammad, my life will be in the hand of Allah. You are a doctor. Just you write the medicine for me. I want to read the words of Allah. Give me my glasses. We are living. Whether we have the glasses or don't have the glasses. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.